Hey everyone, thank you for watching. Today's video is going to be a new one in my declutter series, and I have been seeing the comments. You wanted to see my face palette collection, so here we are. Going through each one and telling you a little bit about my thoughts on them and deciding what I want to keep and what I want to pass on. So I will link my declutter series down below. I've been trying to do these every week. There has been a lot going on in the makeup world and some videos that are kind of a little bit more timely that I do, so I missed a week last week with my declutter series, but I really wanted to come back to do face palettes because I've been seeing all of the comments that you really want to see this one. So like I said, I'll link my playlist down below, but let's go ahead and get started. So I did pull all of my face palettes into the mix, even some of the newer ones that I have in my collection. I don't always show new products in my declutter videos because I'd be keeping them since I, you know, they're newer to me and I'm still trying them to review them, but I thought I could pull everything in because I don't know if this one might surprise people too. I've been getting these comments on a few of my past declutter videos that you have thought that my collections would be even larger. But this is my face palette collection, and truly, it didn't grow too much from the last time that I did this declutter until now. Face palettes were really something that I was trying not to purchase a lot of in 2020, and I feel like I did a pretty good job of that. There's a couple in here that I purchased myself and then a few that I did get in PR, but this is my entire face palette collection, and I know that it's a lot, but to me it's really not that overwhelming. I know that some of these in here I've kind of been keeping around for like nostalgia, memory type of purposes. And then again, there's just some of my favorites in here. I just rolled up my sleeves. I'm not really quite sure how to do this one. I think I'm gonna go ahead and show each product, talk about it a little bit. Maybe I'll add in a few swatches. Might be a lot to try to swatch absolutely everything like I've been doing. And then maybe kind of start piles because this is gonna be such a hard one for me. I feel like looking at this, I'm not really sure. Nothing's jumping out to me like, hey, I could really declutter that one. So I'm just gonna jump into it and get started. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be like doubting myself already. But this one here is at the top, and this is one of my favorites. This is from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Filmstar Bronze and Glow. So you have a contour on one side and then a highlight on the other. This is so beautiful. I had wanted to purchase this one for such a long time, but it is so expensive because it is Charlotte Tilbury, but it really did become a favorite of mine. The powders are so smooth in here. They are just like soft, smooth. The highlight isn't overly blinding, but sometimes that's what I want, and the contour shade blends so easily. I'm such a fan of this one. I reach for it so often. Okay, so it's what I told myself. I'm not going to really do like a pass and declutter pile yet. I kind of just want to go through each one and think about it. Think about it a little bit more, and then maybe look at everything after because sometimes I either talk myself in or out of keeping products as I'm going through. So I'm just going to kind of set it to the side, and then we'll keep on going. Okay, so I have two here from Natasha Denona. I have the Bronze and Glow and then also the Blush and Glow. The Blush and Glow is currently in my Shop to My Stash bag. So normally in my declutters, I do keep the products that I have in my Shop My Stash bag because I then go on to review all those products when I do an update. This one in here, I will say the blush color isn't the absolute best for me, but I really do like the highlight as like an inner corner or brow bone highlight type of shade. I reach into this a lot for that purpose. The blush is almost just like a little bit too bright for me, but I really like these duos. The Bronze and Glow is a favorite though. I am such a fan of this one, and this goes into like my overnight bags, my on-the-go makeup bags so often. I find this to be beautiful. Again, I go into this one all of the time. So I'm a really big fan of these minis from Natasha. I think they're like $19. All right, one of my new palettes, this is from The Balm, and this is the Will Powder Blush Quad. So there are, how I use it, as I use these two as blushes, and then I've been using this one as a highlight. You could use it as a blush topper too. I mean, you could use these for whatever it is that you want, but I included it in the palette one because I do technically use this one as a highlight. This is the only one in here that I don't use as much. Again, that was a reason why I was trying not to purchase face palettes much in 2020, because without filled always seems like there's one shade that isn't working for me, or that I just, you know, don't personally love as much on me. And for me, as like, I could go into my singles or my duos. I'm a big fan of the duos also. I'm a big fan of the duos, like I just shown with the Natasha Denona. But this one from The Balm is really so nice. Okay, I told myself, like, don't feel like you have to swatch absolutely everything, because that could be, you know, get to be a lot. These three shades especially, I just think they're so beautiful. I'm probably not going to do, like, world-class swatches in here also, because I'm just kind of doing a one swipe. I've really been liking this one. Again, I still need to do, like, my actual review of this one on YouTube. So, again, in my regular declutters, I would be keeping it. But I'm a fan. This one and the new bronzer that just released from The Balm that I mentioned in my bronzer declutter, been really enjoying these. Another new one to me, this is from Salt New York. So if you are not familiar with Salt New York, so they are known for their cream products. And what you can do is you can purchase the cream products as singles on the website, and then you can also purchase these really nice palettes. I think this is so fun. It's just different. This is kind of what my wallet looks like. So I feel like it's, you know, just something a little bit more unique and different. So you can purchase these separately. They have smaller ones, they have bigger ones, but this is the quad that I put together for myself. This is pretty newer to me. I've only used these a handful of times so far. I have an Instagram tutorial up using all of these in here, my contour, bronzer, highlight, and then also the blush. Here are some swatches from the quad. So a lot of you know that I don't go into cream products as often as I do my powder. I think that's how I'm gonna start saying it these days. But it's been fun to try these out, so I'm definitely gonna keep testing them to review. Moving over to some that I've had in my collection for a while and kind of give me that like nostalgia type of feeling. This one is from Beauty and the Beast. This was a collaboration with Lorac. I was so feeling on this collection when they sent it to me in PR. I was like losing my mind. I was so excited about it. Look how beautiful this is. You have three blushes and a highlight. Even like when I first got this, and even for the while afterwards, I was taking this with me so often. I was wearing it so often. I just thought it was so beautiful. While I don't reach into it as much these days, a part of me is like, well, you could get rid of it, you know, you don't use it as much. But you know, I remember when I decluttered the Beauty and Beast palette, I was kind of like, oh, should I really do this for the eyeshadow palette? Like, it's, you know, it's so gorgeous, it's so lovely. And I kind of struggle with myself because while I don't want a gigantic collection, I also do want to keep around the products that do bring me joy. And just something about the Beauty and Beast collection, it really did. So this is one where I'm like, I could get rid of it, I just don't really want to. So you can see where my struggle is in this video. Another one is from Zoeva. This is the Basic Moment palette, and this one has a contour, a blush, and a highlight. This was the first product that I tried from Zoeva. This one was sent to me from a subscriber, and I thought it was so sweet because I'd mentioned how I wanted to try Zoeva for a while, but they weren't as like easily accessible for me to get. And so someone sent it over, and I was really appreciative of that. And I really like these powders. Again, they're very soft. I use all three shades out of here. While I haven't reached in for it, this palette recently, I still kind of feel that like I don't really want to give it up. I don't have a whole lot of products from Zoeva, and it's just a nice, you know, it's called a basic moment. Like, it's just kind of a nice basic face palette for me. One of my OGs is from Smashbox. This has been a favorite face palette of mine for such a long time. This is the Cali Contour palette. All right, I will say that I haven't been reaching for this one as much as I used to. I mean, this used to always come in my travel bag, and I wonder just with how 2020 has been and, you know, just not traveling as much, not even doing like overnights as much in places, I just haven't been reaching for this one all that often, because it's like, oh, I'm not going away for 5 days. I can take this and have a contour, a bronzer, a blush, highlight shades, a setting powder. While I haven't gone into it super often, I still feel like it's such a good one to have around. I've been a fan of the Cali Contour since I got it. I realized that I had my MAC Hyper Glow in here. I keep all of my face palettes kind of in the same spot. So this is just a highlight palette. This was shown in my highlight collection declutter video if you want to check that one out. But this one is, I'm going to just go ahead and remove it. I just didn't want people to be like, wait, where'd that MAC palette go? But that's a highlight palette, so that's already been featured. Okay, so to keep it rolling here, let's see, what were we just talking about? Like old school ones. So this one here is from Becca and Jaclyn Hill. This was the Champagne Glow face palette. Again, this is another one that I really don't reach into much more these days, but At the time that I was buying this, I was so excited about it. I wore this palette like crazy after I first bought it. I love both of the highlights. They were just, I wore this so much. It has a lot of good memories with this palette. So I feel like, again, it's another one where it's like I could give it up, but at the same time, I don't want to. You know what I'm saying? So we're just going to set it aside. I'm just going to keep thinking about things. Whew. Let's go over to another new one. So this is one that I did purchase in 2020. And of course, it was right after I made a video on products that I'm trying not to buy as much. And I mentioned face palettes in there for like the reason I mentioned earlier. And then in my very next haul, I had purchased this from Shuwei, the Champagne and Macarons face palette. I was like, please don't judge me too much, but you have a bronzer, two blushes, and a highlight. And honestly, I really don't regret buying this. What I've been really trying to stay away from is buying just blush palettes, just highlight palettes, just bronzer palettes. So especially to have something like this where I do have three different categories of makeup, I go into this so often. I was just wearing it the other day. I wore the bronzer, I mixed the two blushes. The highlight is so beautiful. I'm really such a fan of this. I don't regret buying it. I'm really impressed with the Jouer face products that I have tried. So to have them all in one palette, honestly, I'm not mad. Alrighty, I do have two here from NARS. And I know this is one that I love so much. You might have heard me say in my videos like, oh, I have this NARS trio and I love it so much. This is the one that I am referencing, the Montoutaine palette. And once again, you have a bronzer, a blush, and a highlight inside. Enjoy having three different categories, but also all of the shades work well for me. Again, that cannot always happen with face palettes. It's like maybe the bronzer's an off tone, the blush isn't something that I wear super often, the highlight doesn't show up enough for me, but all three of these work so well, and I reach into this palette so often. So the other one that I have from NARS is the Veil palette, and I really, really liked this one too when it came out. I definitely used the bronzer quite a bit. The blush is just a little bit too much on that watermelon side. It's a little bit too bright, not the exact tone I wear, but the highlight is so beautiful too. Interesting is that they both say they are the Laguna bronzer in these palettes, but you can see from the swatches that they are different. I remember this coming up in my last face palette declutter, and I was like, what is this about? Like, why are they different? But I was reading the comments, and now I can't remember exactly what people were saying, but basically that like there's two different formulas of the Laguna bronzer. You can see one's a little bit more shimmery, one's a little bit more matte. I was like, I'm just a little bit confused, but the thing for me is that I almost kind of like the bronzer in this one a little bit more than the other one. But then again, at the same time, if I was going somewhere and you were like, you have to choose between these two face palettes, I would choose this one. So I'm kind of like, should I declutter the Veil? Or should I not? Because sometimes there is times where I've gone in just for that bronzer. You see my conundrum? Moving over to some products from Ofra Cosmetics. Okay, this one is so beautiful. This came out last year on their holiday time. This is the Hot Cocoa Bronzer Highlighter Compact. Both of the shades in here are, I mean, they're just beautiful. I was such a fan of this one. I believe that this is still available on the Ofra website, or at least that maybe they like brought it back for holiday. I'm pretty sure you can still grab this one, and I think both of these are stunning. Then also from Madison Miller, we have a trio here with a blush and two highlights. Oh, it doesn't say it on here. I want to say this is something about Squad? Miller Squad, maybe? I might be wrong there. But this is also really beautiful, and this blush is so pretty. But I think I also have the single of this blush, but then the highlighters are gorgeous. I mean, I definitely, you know, I have a lot of Ofra highlights, but those are so impressive too. I thought Madison did such a good job on this one. This is such a cute little palette. We're almost done. So let's finish off with some duos again. So this is from Too Faced. Talk about a product I did not expect to enjoy. This is the Pineapple Sun Duo. Inside is a bronzer and a highlight. I don't know. The packaging was cute. I was in store one day. I was like, this looks like fun. So I picked it up and I actually like it a lot. If you can keep hearing Aerie's footsteps, she is pacing back and forth. My husband is putting up our Christmas lights today. She wants to be outside, but it's too cold for her. It's the whole thing. So she's just pacing. But I think that this is so beautiful. And again, I reach into this way more often than I thought I was going to. Like, this was a very successful impulse purchase. And then this is a new one here. This is from Sigma Beauty. This is a part of their holiday collection. How absolutely beautiful is this? And this is the Rose Glow Cheek Duo. This, I'm such a fan of. From the first time I started trying it, I was like, yes, please. The highlight is so stunning. The blush is the Corda Rosa, which is, look at that, so beautiful. The Sigma Holiday Collection typically does not disappoint. You know how there's sometimes from other brands, there's some holiday collections that you're like, not as good as their usual stuff. I mean, I feel like Sigma's is, right on par with what they usually release. And this duo is so good. Finish it off with some palettes. This is the Queen palette from Juvia's Place in collaboration with Fumi, who is such a fantastic human being. This is the palette that she created. And for me, when I first opened this, I was like, okay, I'm probably not going to get a ton of use out of it, but that's all right. But it's actually like sneaky easy for me to use. I use it for some eye shades, but I do also use it for some face shades. Sister to Sister, beautiful blush shade. Like it's so gorgeous. I've used it in a video recently here on YouTube, but this highlight, I mean, are you joking me? Like, these are gorgeous. And then the other shades, again, I've used the purple on my eyes before. I've used the red on my eyes before. This is a really beautiful shimmer also. Like, look at this one. Like, what? Are you kidding me? And that was, I mean, you saw, that was one swipe. That was one swipe. This is beautiful. I mean, it's a very multi-use palette. I don't have a ton of those in my collection, but I'm just like, I can't give it up. I mean, look at this queen. From Too Faced, we have the Natural Face Palette. Once again, I don't want to say that I wasn't expecting to enjoy it, but I think because I thought that I would, and I was interested in it when it first came out. I was like, actually, that looks really beautiful, catches my attention, but I really didn't think I was going to like it as much as I did. The bronzers are both beautiful. The blushes, especially Pink Sand, like that is such a beautiful neutral blush. It's just gorgeous. Sunny Honey is definitely the bronzer that I use the most of. The highlights are actually what I don't prefer the most, but they're still really pretty. Let me see if I got some fingers left to do all the swatching. Like, I mean, those highlights are really gorgeous. They're a little bit more of like duochrome-ish type of feeling, which isn't always my favorite. Really the one out of the palette that I don't use a lot of is Pink Wink, because again, it's kind of that brighter blush. But if I mix it with Pink Sand, I do think that it's pretty. So this is another one that I was like, oh, sneaky good palette, okay? And then lastly, we have the one from Hourglass. This is the Ambient Lighting Edit Volume 4. And if you've been around for a while, you've known my like ups and downs with this palette. When I first got it, I was like, I don't really understand it, not sure what's going on. This is a gift from a subscriber also, and I was like, I really want to like it, but I don't really understand the Hourglass powders. Didn't see the hype with them, and I have been slowly changing my mind, and now I'm actually really glad to have this palette. The bronzer was pretty much always my favorite in here. I think that it's beautiful, but even some of these finishing powders, I'm now understanding how to use them a little bit more. If you can see that, it just kind of blurs out the skin so beautifully, and you know, look at that. Like, that's, I don't know, that's just wild to me what this can do. And I did not understand it before. And I don't know, maybe it has something to do with my skin maturing from when I first started on YouTube and started trying these powders and was like, I don't get it. But now I can see a big difference when I use these, which kind of pains me at the same time. Also, this blush is really, I think that one's a really fun one too. So I have definitely come around on the Hourglass powders, but also this one in general. I'm trying not to, like, I don't know, you wanna see my fan? There it is. Definitely been a big fan of this one. So, okay, I don't know if that really helped me as much as I was hoping it would. Let me pull all the palettes back out and let me take a look at them and try to figure out what in the heck I'm doing with this video. All right, so here it is. This is my entire face palette collection. Those are all of my thoughts and some swatches on these. And I'm looking around and I don't think I'm going to declutter any of them. I I mean, this, I had planned for this to be a declutter, but when I was pulling everything out, I just wasn't sure. And as I go through them, I enjoy all of these. You know, some of these are new. Maybe I won't keep them after I've tried them some more. Some of these are new. Some of these are old staples. Some of these, maybe I don't use as much anymore, but they still bring me so many good memories. To me, I don't get overwhelmed looking at this because I see each product in here, and there's a reason why I enjoy it so much, and there's a reason why I want to keep it. And I don't want to get rid of any of them. So I'm going to be hanging on to all of my face palettes, but I hope that you at least enjoyed seeing my collection, because I know a lot of you have been saying that you wanted to see my collection. I hope hearing some of my thoughts on these and seeing the swatches were helpful, and I hope that you enjoyed it. I don't think that this will really happen with any of my other declutter videos. I think there will be actual decluttering happening. This is just kind of one of those oddball categories that I keep a little bit more curated, and I enjoy it all. So I hope that you still had fun with this video. I hope no one's too mad that I did not declutter anything, but if you liked it, make sure you give this one a thumbs up. I hope you also consider subscribing before you go, and I will see you in my next video. Goodbye.